acts. God sends His Holy Spirit.
But I promise you this, the Holy Spirit will come upon you and you will be seized with power. And you will be my messengers to Jerusalem, throughout Judea, the distant provinces, and even to the remotest places on earth. Acts 1, verse 8. Acts 2, verse 1 to 13.
Before Jesus had gone up to heaven, He told His disciples to go back to Jerusalem, where they were supposed to wait until God's Holy Spirit came upon them.
One day, while they were meeting together, the disciples heard a noise that sounded like the roar of a mighty wind. Even though the windows and the doors were closed, the whirling wind started blowing inside the house. Something that looked like tongues of fire appeared on each of the disciples' heads. It didn't burn them or hurt them. God sent His Holy Spirit to live inside of them, just as Jesus had promised. When the Holy Spirit filled them, they were given the power to speak in languages they had not known before. This is a special gift given by the Holy Spirit.
Jewish people from every country in the world had come to Jerusalem to celebrate the Passover. When they heard the disciples speaking in their language, they were amazed and confused.
What does this mean?
Some of them asked.
Did you drink too much wine?
Another asked. Then Peter stood up with 11 other disciples and he explained to the crowd.
Fellow Jews, and all of you who live in Jerusalem, let me explain this to you. Listen carefully to what I say. These men are not drunk. What has happened here was predicted by the prophet Joel when he said, "In the last days, God says, I will pour out my spirit on all people. Your sons and daughters will prophesy. Your young men will see visions. Your old men will dream dreams."
The Holy Spirit gave Peter courage to preach to the crowd. He was no longer afraid to admit that he knows Jesus. He told the people that even though they had killed Jesus, God had brought him back to life. This proved that Jesus was the Savior of the world whom the prophets had told about. Many people believed the message Peter preached that day. The people felt ashamed of what they had done.
What do we do now?
They asked.
Turn away from your sin.
Peter answered them.
Turn to God and be baptized in the name of Jesus Christ. Then your sins will be forgiven. The Holy Spirit will be given to you as a gift, just as He was given to us. God has promised to send His Holy Spirit to everyone who will obey Him.
Thousands of people believed in the Lord Jesus that day, and they were baptized. They began meeting together regularly to learn more about Jesus from the apostles and to pray together.
Here we discover that the Holy Spirit is part of the Holy Trinity of God, the Father, the Son, and the Holy Spirit. Everyone who believes in Him and calls on the name of the Lord will be saved. God gives His Holy Spirit as a free gift to everyone who believes in Him and obeys Him. The Holy Spirit helps us to be brave so that we can tell others about God and His great love for us.
Memorize. If anyone became one with Christ, accepting this new identity, he has become an entirely new person. Everything that belonged to the old person has died with Jesus on the cross. He has made everything fresh and new. 2 Corinthians 5, verse 17.